Hey everybody, Dr. Rob Silverman here, 2015 Sports Chiropractor of the Year and author of Amazon number one best-selling book, Inside Out Health. I want to share with you some breakthroughs in how to treat concussion, whether it's in acute state or in a long-term state. Man, oh man, I mean, I see so many concussion patients and it's so disconcerting to me to see the status of where they're in. So number one, if you want a little more information about me or you want to contact me, drrobertsilverman.com. Give me a call, love to talk to you. Any time of the day, any time of the night. Treating concussion is my passion. Some overviews. Number one with concussion, what people don't realize now is that when you injure your head and you hit your head and you have that shaking of that brain tissue, it's now at the axonal level. It's those nerves in the brain that are ripping apart, and that's posing an issue. Some other things that we're not realizing is when we injure our head, we also have gastrointestinal upset. So with the gut and the brain being a bi-directional connection, if all we do is emphasize treatment at the brain level and we don't treat the gut level, we're never truly gonna fix that, once again, that bi-directional, that whole system. And it's a system from here to there. So I wanna go over some after and targeted treatment enhanced recovery tools that you can share with all your former NFL and current NFL players. Number one, here's my Dr. Rob's concussion protocol. It's a multi-system approach. It's unfortunately, it's not just one thing. The first thing you wanna look at is the musculoskeletal system. So once we know that they've had a concussion and they have post-concussion syndrome, there's specific muscles that we can work on and release. The one that comes to mind is called the rectus capitis posterior minor. It's one small muscle that's up here in that ridge, that occipital ridge that you feel. That muscle has the most myodural power. Myodural power, it's a muscle that actually affects the dural sheath and affects how the brain thinks. So as a chiropractor, there's soft tissue and exercise rehab that we can give to help with that myodural connection in those particular muscles. There's tremendous literature in 2016 and 2017 speaking to that area and releasing those muscles. In addition, balance and visual disturbances. One of the things you notice from a lot of these players is they walk with an altered gait, they can't seem to stand on one leg, they can't ambulate okay. They need to be retrained, they need to get what we call proprioception. Proprioception is the balance between your nervous system and your muscular system so you can ambulate and stand. If you see they're walking all over the place, and the best way to do that is through what we call gaze stabilization, because they have visual disturbances. They wear a lot of sunglasses, they can't see. So gaze stabilization is a training method that we have here that enables people to take visual stimuli and stimulate their proprioceptive balance ideology. It is a great takeaway. A lot of new literature in the last 2 or 3 months that pertains to this visual gaze stabilization to get them over visual disturbances. That's two things. The third thing is everything's pointed at increasing BDNF, brain-derived neurotrophic factors. That is a protein enzyme in the brain. There's been a breakthrough with our idea. We now know that the brain can recover. The brain can grow nerves. That's why we call it neurogenesis. We never knew that 3 years ago, but all the literature points at this protein enzyme and the stimulation of this protein enzyme and enabling people to have neurogenesis and overcome any kind of traumatic brain injury and or concussion. So how do I recommend getting brain-derived neurotrophic factors stimulated? One great way is the nutritional support. So what enables BDNF? Turmeric. Turmeric is an herb that has an active ingredient called curcumin. This really decreases inflammation and upregulates brain-derived neurotrophic factors. Lots and lots of robust literature speak to the idea of fish oils, omega-3, most commonly DHA. DHA has really shown to help stimulate brain-derived neurotrophic factors and also help cell membranes, your brain cell membrane, to heal. In addition to that, exercise has shown steady state walking and moving, helping brain-derived neurotrophic factor. Alpha lipoic acid, a great antioxidant. It works with the watering the fat part of the cell. It's shown to, without question, help the brain respond by increasing brain-derived neurotrophic factor. In addition, I recommend a form of magnesium, magnesium L-threonate. Magnesium L-threonate was studied in September 2016 by MIT, and it's shown to pass the brain-blood-brain barrier and get into what we call the cerebrospinal fluid. And by passing, about 15% is able to pass. It decreases aging in the brain from 9 to 15% and decreases the incidence of Alzheimer's by 80%. So magnesium L-threonate is a real home run to be able to ingest. Another nutrient that we found to be so positive is glutathione, the body's biggest intracellular antioxidant. It was studied and published in Sports Illustrated in 2014. If you're able to get glutathione in, it decreases brain tissue damage by 70%. So these are some of the nutritional support and supplements that I recommend to help with acute and chronic traumatic brain injury and post-concussion. And finally, one of the things I really like to talk about is laser. I use a low-level laser here. That low-level laser is known to decrease pain and increase range of motion, but it works at a cellular level. It decreases inflammation. It doesn't allow these cytokines and other inflammatory markers to continue damaging the brain. It also upregulates healing and stops cell death. Interesting, the laser, I've gotten phenomenal results in outcome with post-concussion syndrome. And finally, the key component, we talked about the brain to gut at the beginning, vagus nerve stimulation. Vagus nerve stimulation is a critical element. The vagus nerve is a parasympathetic nerve that is the walkie-talkie between the brain and the gut. This is a critical element. When you're able to stimulate the vagus nerve, you get a better clinical outcome with your brain. And the last thing is, let's get all these ex-NFL players exercising. Because exercise, you got to use it so you don't lose it. And exercise helps brain-derived neurotrophic factors. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me. My website is drrobertsilverman.com. My office number is 914-287-6464. Cell 917-596-2227. Always yours in health, Dr. Rob Silverman.